Well, hello there, people. We are going down memory lane like a little good rabbit here. People have been asking me about my distributions that I use, and depending on what day you ask, you get a different answer. So I think I will make this video so I can basically just say, hey, you know what? Watch this video. So I will not go and say each and individual little distribution, because if it's on DistroWatch, I have probably installed it at some point. And yes, I also mean the dormant and the not active distributions anymore, because we are going to talk about a lot of history right now. What I am going to do is I'm putting it into block of years. Yes, block of years. And I will highlight the distribution I'm used most in that certain time. I hope this makes sense, because we have to, you know, cover our bases here when we are on the interwebs. So, I got exposed to Linux in the mid-90s. Yes, 1995-6ish, I got exposed to Linux. My first ever Linux distribution I installed was called Red Hat Linux. Not Red Hat Enterprise Linux, not Fedora. It was called Red Hat Linux. And that was around 96 or 7 is like when I was a teenager. And I used it and installed it on and off. And I also, in that area, so when we are talking, like that was my first ever distribution. But now we are going to say from 95 to 2000, what distributions did I use the most from 95 to 2000 is what we're going to talk about. Of course, that would be Red Hat. I can't remember the version number. It's so many years ago. And I think I dabbled a little bit with Debian also, like installed it. And I OpenSUSE was also one that I installed, and Mandrake. But I think I primarily used, like out of those, I primarily used Red Hat and OpenSUSE. A little trivia here, I use distributions where we got the whole repository in CD or DVD form because I have crappy internet. And back then, you ordered, you know, installation CDs or DVDs. And SUSE and Mandrake and Debian, you can order a CD with those that had all of the repository on it. So that's what I did. So from 2000 to 2005, the main distributions I ran there would have been Mandrake and OpenSUSE and Debian. Either it was Mandrake itself or Mantrivo, I can't remember when they changed name. Back then it was not called OpenSUSE, it was called SUSE. So until it became OpenSUSE, it was SUSE. And then when it became OpenSUSE, I used OpenSUSE, of course. I can't remember when they changed the name to OpenSUSE. And of course, and then a Debian spin, either Debian or Debian spin. And Mandrake. Those were like the most, you know, the ones that I ran the most. Then from 2005 to 2010, it became SUSE or OpenSUSE, Mantrivo, Mandrake. And instead of Debian, I moved over to Ubuntu-based distributions. And I started to mess around with Arch in like 2006, but I didn't really main it. It was just something I messed around with. I also messed around with Gentoo and Slackware. I had like a year where I ran a year with Slackware and a year with Gentoo, and that was around 2005-6, I can't remember. But from 2005 to 2010, it was mostly SUSE, OpenSUSE, Mantrivo, Mandrake, depending on when they changed their name, and some form of Ubuntu mixed in with like a Slackware and an Arch install. From 2010 up till around 2015, it was mostly Arch, Debian, Arch, Ubuntu, and sometimes I'd be running OpenSUSE and rarely be running Mandrake, Mantrivo, because I kind of got out of love, or the Mantrivo, I think it was already called Mantrivo back then, the Mantrivo project was kind of becoming a little bit stagnated. And it didn't take long before they split into, like, basically the developers made their own mature distribution that we have nowadays. From 2015 and then up till now, it has primarily been some form of Ubuntu base, Arch base, or Debian testing base. Sometimes OpenSUSE, but that's the one I have primarily run. So that's like, if you look at, okay, which distributions I have spent the most time on in those period. And like I said, the last couple of years, like the last 4 years or something like that, it has mostly been Ubuntu and Arch. The last 2 years, mostly Ubuntu. I'm getting a little bit tired of all of the maintenance that Arch and updating and stuff. Like I'm just getting tired of rolling releases, to be honest. So I tend to spend more time in Ubuntu. So distributions that may be, you know, fun to think about that I used to over my Linux lifetime here is that I Zenwalk, that's a Debian, not Debian, a Slackware base, Slackix, what it was called, it was a Slackware base, I ran that for a little while. Libre or Libra OS or something like that, that was a short-lived Debian-based distribution. It was something with Libra or something, I can't remember it. I think it was made in Canada or something like that, I can't remember. A Vector OS that's still around, I ran that on and off for around a year or 2 years. Now I'm just trying to remember all the distributions that I spent like somewhat time on, and I can't remember when I did it. Or so, what is it called? Sebion Linux, that is a Gentoo spin-off. I kind of like that actually quite a lot. I actually used that quite a lot in a period of time, like in a 6 month period of time. I messed around with Linux from scratch a little bit. I messed around with the FreeBSD, like install it, ran it for like a month or so, and then, you know, tried Dragonfly BSD and other BSDs, but they were like, it was like for a week, a month, and then I got tired of it and I moved on. Is there other noteworthy distributions that I ran for a period of time? Mint. I used Mint for like almost a year at some point. In the beginning of when Mint came out, I was actually quite a bit of a Mint fanboy. But back then it was like it is today heavily Ubuntu based, so I kind of took it under a Ubuntu based. I was a big Sorian fan when they came out, not anymore, but I used to be. Is there any other specific distribution? I kind of have to go on to DistroWatch and look at the discontinued distributions, because like I said, if there is a distribution on DistroWatch, I have installed it at some point, either in a virtual machine or in physical hardware, and ran it for more than a week. What are your main distributions you have run through the years? Like, do it, like I said, within like a 5 to 10 year year span. And the sad reality is that most of you people that are watching my videos right now probably not run Linux for more than 4 years or 5 years. That seems to be the average lifespan that people run Linux on. See you all later. Bye-bye.